Hello friends, as you all know that the UPSC prelims examination of 2020 is scheduled on 31st of May, and as if the things go fine, the coronavirus situation is fine, then we can expect that the exam will not postpone and it will occur on 31st May only. I have made this video to tell you how to prepare for the UPSC prelims examination in the last 2 months. So you have 2 months for it right now, that is 60 days you have right now, and I will suggest a strategy to you to how to approach examination in the last 2 months. So for the next month, that is till April 30th, you can prepare for the prelims as well as the mains, and in this month you can also study the new topics also. However, in the last month you cannot study anything new, and you have to study for the prelims only, and you have to study and revise for the prelims only. Thus your preparation strategy can be divided into two parts, that is for the month of April and then for the month of May. So for the month of April, I would like to tell you that you have to revise all the general studies paper, that is general studies paper 1, paper 2, paper 3 and paper 4 at least for once. You have to finish the course at least for once, because after the prelims examination you won't get that much time to prepare for the mains examination, because the time gap will be very less. Secondly, after the prelims examination you have to undergo the test series also, you have to do some writing practice also. So it is better that you complete the mains course right now only in the month of April. Secondly, in the month of April you should also revise your optional paper at least once, because of the same reason that after prelims you won't be able to do it. After prelims you have to revise the mains syllabus. You cannot study the main syllabus for the first time after the prelims examination. Thirdly, in the month of April, what you try to do is that you try to write at least 4 essays, that is at least one essay in a week on current issues like coronavirus 2019, communal harmony, citizenship of India and NRC, refugee problem in India, mask diplomacy, economic slowdown of India, terrorist attack in Afghanistan and Islamic State. So such kind of topics you can pick out from the current happenings of the month of April or of the year 2020, and then write essays on it, so that it will help in your mains preparation as well as your prelims preparation, as well as it will help you in writing good essays. And one important thing to be done in the month of April is that you should revise all the last year question papers of last 30 years of the UPSC prelims examination. Along with the UPSC prelims examination, you should also revise the question papers of other state PSC examination like UP PSC, Madhya Pradesh PSC, Rajasthan PSC, Jharkhand PSC, Bihar PSC or the PSC of your home state. And another important thing to be done in the month of April is that you should revise the current affairs of last 1 year that you have made, the current affair note that you have made. You have to revise in the last 1 year, and if you have not made the notes of current affairs of last 1 year, then that is not a good thing. However, if you have not made the notes of last 1 year current affairs, then you have to revise from some other current affairs source like the Vision IAS website or any other website of that kind. In the second last month, that is the month of April, you don't have to read from any new book. Read from only those books which you have already read from. Don't try to read from new sources. Don't try to read from the materials available in the market. Read from only those books, only those sources which you have already read from. I have made a list of the books that you can ponder upon. I hope you have read all those books. These are the most important books that a person has to read from before undergoing the prelims examination. The first of all, the most important book is the India book, which is published by the Ministry of Information and Broadcasting. So what you have to do is you have to complete its revision at least 2 times till the end of the month of April. Then another important source is Economic Survey, which is published by the Ministry of Finance. You have to read the Economic Survey at least for 2 times till the end of month of April. Similarly, you have to keep on reading the newspaper in the month of April. Continue reading it. Then you have to read the books which you have already read. For example, for culture, you can read the NIOS notes. You can read the book by A.L. Basham. For ancient history, medieval history, modern history, you can read the old NCRTs or the book by Bipin Chandra. Then you can read geography from new NCRTs. You can read environment from Airag Bharuch. You can read sociology from the class 11th and 12th new NCRTs. And then you can read world history from old NCRTs. And India after independence from the book by Bipin Chandra. Then for polity, you can read the book by D.D. Basu or by Lakshmikant. And you can also refer to my book on public administration and public policy for certain good topics, for the comparison of constitution of different countries. Then you can read the reports of Administrative Reforms Commission. Then you can read my book on public administration for referring to Citizens Charter. You can read the annual reports of Ministry of Home Affairs. Then for economics, you can read the new NCRTs of 11th and 12th. I already told you that you have to read Economic Survey and India Yearbook. That is important for economics section also. For science and technology, you have to rely on the newspaper. So you have to read the newspaper of last 1 year. For security, you can read my book on internal security and revise it at least 2 times. For disaster management also, you can read my book on internal security. For land reforms, you can read the geography section. Similarly, you can revise the general studies paper 4 from different sources that you have already read from. And you can also read case studies from my book, Internal Security and Introduction to Civil Services. So these are just a glimpse of the books which you can read and complete till the month of April end. And when the month of May will start, you shall stop reading newspapers, because the current affairs of the month of May won't be coming in the examination. The current affairs till the end of April would only be coming in the examination. So you can stop reading the newspaper in the last month. Secondly, what you should do is that you should again, at least once, revise the current affairs of last 1 year. And again, you should revise the last 30 years question papers of UPSC, UPPSC, MPPSC, BPSC, RPSC and your own state PSC. And revise everything which you have revised for 1 time, 2 times in the month of April. Means the topics which would be coming in the prelims examination, you should revise at least 1 time more. In the month of May, your target should be that you should read at least India book for 3 times before the prelims examination, Economic Survey at least for 3 times, NCRTs at least for 3 times, and other important books that I mentioned at least for 3 times before appearing in the prelims examination. So what you have to do after the prelims examination, the books that you have read at least for 3 times, you have to read them at least 1 time more before the main examination. So that makes a revision of total 4 times before the main examination. So when you read all these things for the prelims examination, I think 90% of the paper would be from these sources only. What UPSC may do is that they may ask 5% to 10% questions which are not from these sources. Those questions are asked just to divert your attention and misguide you. So most of the questions are from the traditional sources only, from the last year question papers only, but certain questions are there which are there to divert your attention and waste your time. So I request you to not focus on those questions, but focus on the 90% of the paper and try to score as much marks as you can. But don't panic in the last 2 months. Just relax and study what I have told you and try to score as much marks as you can, because when you write the prelims examination, at that time only you must be confident that you will qualify the prelims examination. Because if you wait for the results of the prelims examination, then much of your time will be wasted and you won't be able to prepare for the mains examination in a good manner. So you should be very confident that you will qualify the prelims examination, and then you should start preparing for the mains examination right from the day you have given the prelims examination. So I wish you best of luck for the prelims examination and for also for the other examinations, including the mains examination and the interview stage of the examination. Thank you.